Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Many a True Nerd, and welcome to the Turing Test, a psychologically narrative-y, exploring-y, mystery-y sort of game in a sci-fi setting. So yeah, this is my sort of bag right here. Kind of think like Soma, that sort of thing. Really enjoyed that. Been looking forward to this for quite a while too. Let's dive in, shall we?
Morning, Eva.
Morning, Tom.
Your wake-up has been sanctioned by the ISA. We lost contact with the ground crew 450 hours ago. We have tried to establish further communications, but we are not getting any responses. We need you to investigate.
Okay, doesn't it make sense to do visual checks first?
We have already looked at the data. The ISA has made the executive decision that you report to the surface post-haste. You are our emergency response.
What exactly is the emergency?
The ground crew found an organism the ISA believed to be dangerous. We need to re-establish communication.
I feel like there's follow-up questions to ask here. Like, we're in space and we just found an alien. And there's Jupiter, by the way. Ooh, straight over to the flipping window. Yeah, we're around Jupiter. Or rather, to be precise, my understanding is we are around Europa, one of the moons of Jupiter. I'm not sure if that's one of the ones that we know already has ice on it, because of course we do know there is ice elsewhere in our solar system. I know it's Saturn's moon. Isn't it Titan? Around Saturn, that's actually got like ice on it, huge layers of ice, where theoretically if there was going to be life somewhere else in the solar system, that's theoretically where it would be. For those of you who don't know, by the way, the Turing Test, the name of the game, this is probably going to be important. The Turing Test was a test developed a very long time ago by a scientist, brilliant scientist, did all sorts of amazing things, Alan Turing. But the Turing Test in particular was basically his hypothesis that if you could have a human chatting to another human and also a robot at the same time through like a text interface, if the human couldn't tell when they were speaking to a human and when they were speaking to a robot, well, in that case, the machine was capable of communicating with a human as effectively as another human. And that kind of raises all sorts of interesting questions philosophically and so forth. So clearly something in this game is going to be about machines, humans, philosophy, all that sort of thing, which means I don't trust Tom one little bit. And not just because he's not symmetrical. The human eye likes symmetrical things and you are not symmetrical. I'm watching you, you robo bastard. Let's be on our way to Europa, shall we? Which apparently we have been told to go and visit by the International Space Agency. It was originally going to be called the International Society for the Investigation of Space, but, you know. And I'm guessing inside these other parts are, yes, other doctors and other kind of scientists and stuff. So everyone's in cryo and only gets woken up by the machines when we are actually, ooh, hang on, does that mean I know who I am? Yes, I'm Ava Turing. Well, that's bloody convenient, isn't it? Marvellous. Cryogenic awakening was 2250. So these guys are not going to be woken up for... Not for centuries. Okay, everyone else is... Oh, hang on. Wait a second. Pod malfunction. And the pod malfunction was, like, recently. Like, May the 12th. Hang on. What date was mine? May the 14th, was it? May the 13th. Yesterday there was a pod malfunction. Hello? Oh no, and it was a Canadian! I love Canadians. Canadians are awesome. Oh no. I think we might have a dead Canadian in there somewhere. I'm very sorry if so. But you know what? Don't worry about the dead Canadian. Let's get down to Europa and figure out what's going on here. Okay, so some things I can interact with. I can grab them with X. Lovely. And then I've got myself an ISA mug. Lovely. And then pop it straight back down where I found it. What's one of you? Just, random briefcase. Can I do anything with it? No, I can just put it back down afterwards. Okay. One keypad. One, two, three, four, five, six. Done. How about 000000? I was hopeful there for a second. Those were the two codes I used on my space luggage. All right. Straight through here then to the armory. Ooh, pick up your EMT. Thanks, Tom. What is an EMT exactly? Ooh, it's a space gun!
We are going to take a lander to Europa. Make your way to the docking station.
Should I not take a spacesuit? I feel like we could use a spacesuit as well. Also, the instruction booklet from a space gun. This seems useful. Ooh, well, I know it's an energy manipulation tool. I can't take it with me and I can't read it, but I do now know what an EMT is. Well, now I'm deeply suspicious. Tom wants me to just head on this way to get in a lander. Still this office we haven't unlocked. What's in this office? What's the code? Where's the code? Because there's no way to... Ooh. This is all very mysterious. Okay, fine. Ignore the office that I can't get into. Hello. Oh, an open office. Maybe I can get a code in here. No code, but there is a torch that, again, I can pick up but not take. I feel like I'm leaving a lot of stuff I could use. Ooh. Open system. Open system. This seems useful. Yes. This is my own mail system. I'm guessing this is actually my office, in fact. So, to Ava, the current ship status is as following. Recommend addressing the power fluctuations before cryostasis. I really hope I did that, because if I didn't, I may be responsible for a dead Canadian. I also wrote to Dan McLean. So, Dan, I'm about to initiate my cryostasis. Just let Tom know if you guys need me. Hopefully there'll be no need to wake me. I guess I'll hear from you as soon as I wake up, which may be a long time for you guys. Best of luck down there, Ava. Okay. Ava, hopefully we won't need you. We will miss you in the land of the living. I'll make sure Tom checks up on you regularly. I know he does anyway. I like to think I'm helping. Good night from Dan. Okay, so we need to go and find Dan, whoever Dan is. Oh, Dan's the captain. Fine, to Ava. Captain McLean has sent several mails insisting I check the cryo chambers are functioning correctly. They are functioning as expected. Please do not feel any apprehension. Captain McLean has been informed. I'm guessing that indeed comes from Tom. Oh yes, the technical operations machine. Oh, Tom, the technical operations machine. Okay, now I know Tom stands for something. I like him a bit better. He seems lovely. Thank you, Tom. I'm not worried. But audio logs first.
I think that's everything wound up, Tom.
Yes.
Well, I guess I'm ready to go down for the long sleep then.
Good night, Ava. I will miss your assistance. The ship will be very quiet without you here.
Night. See you when I wake up, Tom.
You see, if you don't want me to assume the robot is evil, don't give him a deep British voice. That's pretty much who all the villains are in films. Ooh, a wibbly thing. I don't know what a wibbly thing does, but in sci-fi, I always like a wibbly thing. Especially when a wibbly thing is opposite a window that lets me see Jupiter. I love sci-fi. Sci-fi is my favourite setting for everything.
Bay 3.
Bay 3, you say? Oh, no. I'm checking the other bays first, alright? You can't stop me. This is standard video game logic right here. The moment you know where you're supposed to go, explore literally everywhere else first. Okay, fine. On this occasion, he was right. I was supposed to just go to Bay 3. Ooh, I get a little drop pod. I love a drop pod. A good drop pod's a fantastic way to start a sci-fi game. In we go. It's like the start of Bioshock Infinite, but in reverse, and in space, and with no lighthouse, and with a woman. Okay, it's not very much like Bioshock Infinite.
Retro?
Go.
Fido?
Go.
Guidance?
Go.
Control?
Go.
Telcom?
Go.
Then we are go for launch, initiating.
Zephyr.
You know what I like? When a sci-fi game does proper, like, mechanical checks
engaging
and stuff.
Retrofire.
So it genuinely feels like there's a proper serious process going on. And down we come onto the ice sheets of Europa. Beautiful. And the entrance to our nice little bunker here. Oh, I love starting here. Though, admittedly, now we've started in space and we've actually left the station. What was the locked office for? Now I'm really suspicious. And there we are. Now, how exactly do we get back up, by the way? I hope this thing can launch again. I really hope so. We got ourselves a bunker right here. Hang on, just need to check everywhere else first. Oh, sorry, I forgot why we came to Europa in the first place, to harvest its bountiful natural supply of invisible walls.
How long will my suit survive these conditions?
At 100 degrees Kelvin, a couple of hours. We should get inside.
All right, in we go. Shut the door behind me if you'd be so kind. Or don't, just leave it open, whatever. And we're inside and Ava's drawn her gun. Intriguing. And the gun goes... Alternatively, it goes... This gun doesn't do anything. I think they've just given me a play fake gun that just makes a buzzy noise to make me feel better.
The base has changed.
What do you mean?
The base was originally constructed as modules to withstand the seismic activity in and around Thera Macula. It appears the ground team have manipulated these modules.
Okay. And then we've got... Cube thing. You know what? When you're in a game like this, just grab the cube and shove the cube in the thing. Alright, that's generally a safe bet right there. So that's a power cell, lovely. And then through we go into Sector A2.
The base was built initially by machines. I served as the mind of these operations. I arrived first on Europa in 2240. It costs a lot to send humans into space with the necessary life support, especially such a vast distance from Earth. So, Robotics built this place.
That makes sense. And are you the same Tom that was up in the station? You've just, well, I guess you must be. You're just software, so you can just put yourself in all the cameras. Fine, so grabby thingy. Ooh. Don't grabby thingy. Grab the energy out of thingy and zap energy into thingy. Okay. Energy gun can actually transfer energy around. Okay, so we're not actually moving blocks around. We're just pulling energy out of stuff. Now, can I grab the energy out of the thing and then... No, I cannot grab the energy and then get through the door anyway. The game is wise to my tricks. On to Sector A3.
I wonder why the ground team has changed these rooms.
I have a hypothesis. These rooms are Turing tests.
Turing tests?
Turing tests are tests designed to tell humans and machines apart. Typically, problems only solvable by a human. A combination of logical and lateral thinking.
So, you can't complete these tests, Tom?
No. That is why I am glad you are here to help. We need to work together.
Oh, I'm immediately suspicious. I mean, he claims that the ISA authorized me to be woken up, but if these guys have set up tests to try and fool a robot, then he could have just woken me up and straight away said, hey, you need to solve these tests. He just wanted me to open the way for him. Why does he need the way opening? Because surely, well, maybe until the test is solved, power can't go through the modular things. Also, I can't move this upstairs, but neither do I need to. If I just put this down and then climb up here, then presumably I can just suck the energy out of it, right? So I don't actually need that, do I? Oh, there's no glass there. I can just put it straight through the window. Fine. Okay, in that case, just climb through. Sorry, I just kind of assumed there'd be glass there, but no. No, there was not. Then downy here, grabby thing, and then shovey thing into thing. So, yeah, interesting the definition of Turing test he gave there. Because, yes, well, as I said earlier, the Turing test was an experiment kind of designed to see if we could tell the difference between humans and machines. The purpose of the experiment originally, Alan Turing's original experiment, was never to kind of try and separate humans and machines. His hypothesis, I actually read up on this, his hypothesis was that machines would be able to pass a Turing test within 5 minutes of communicating with a human 70% of the time. So it wasn't really so much about, you know, separating humans or proving that humans were separate or creating things that machines couldn't crack or kind of catching machines out. It was about demonstrating that machines could easily be interchangeable with humans. So whether I'm supposed to kind of take anything out of that, whether that's leading up to a twist of some description that things are not quite as they appear, who knows? Into Sector 4.
They really have completely repurposed these rooms. I am quite impressed.
So, what were they used for before?
Most of them were used for storage. But they have converted them beyond recognition. Perhaps they ran out of things to do out here. The devil makes work for idle hands.
Seriously, if you're gonna give Tom that voice, just give him a little twirly mustache underneath his cameras and be done with it. Right. Suck out some power. Okay. That closes that door. But where is the power supposed to go? Ah, wait, hang on. Switchy. Okay, hold switch. And then change the power source. And that opens here. And, oh, that was actually it. Fine, it was just teaching me how to use a switch. Fine. Next up, through here. Ah, grabby through window to close thing. And then shove in here. Lovely, straight onwards. Into 6.
Do you know the ground team's location?
The crew are deeper inside the base, it seems.
They must be trying to survive. Can you find their precise location?
I'm afraid not. I am working to regain control. Though I once had complete control of this base, a lot has changed in the past 500 hours.
Okay, yeah, I'm... Oh, hang on. Wait. Okay, so that there is glass. So I can't just go around here. If I put that into here, this opens up. Then I can't pull this out of there. Okay, hang on here. Wait. Oh, wait. I see. Pull that out of here. Move that up to there. Yeah, that opens that door. And then I can... Wait, hang on. Well, then how do I get up there myself in that case? Wait, I need to do this in a different order. Okay, time for a test. Are these things interchangeable? So can I pop this down here and then... Yes! Yes, I can. Okay, so you can open any of these with either a box or a blast. So now that I've swapped their positions round, I can go round here. Now I can get this and I can use this to open that. Right, so boxes and blobs of energy are interchangeable. Got it.
So if this base is managed by you, why can't you find the crew?
The base's communication array is malfunctioning.
Yeah, you say that. I don't trust you in the slightest, deep-voiced British villain robot. And then what is that over there? Suck some green energy out of that. And then that turns that off. What even is this? That, hang on. What am I looking at here? Hello? I'm about to get myself squished in the name of science. No, I'm fine. It's doing something. It's creating a wibble. Got it. Oh, it's a magnet. Right, all right. So grab it. Ooh, it's a magnet that goes really, really bloody fast. And then move over. There we are. So that thing's now down there. Now I can pull that out. Yeah, we don't need that anymore. Shove that over there. And then grab the one we just pulled down. That was just a big old magnet thing. And then shove this in here. And that should be... Yep, straight on though. I think there's a little bit more to this room than what I've just seen. What exactly... is this area right here? This is off the beaten track. What's this for? Hello?
Perhaps we can't solve this yet.
So there's two things lit up here. And right. We did specifically say perhaps we can't solve this yet, so... yeah. Other than making some nice pretty patterns here, I'm not sure what it is we'd do. Alright, fine. Ooh! I like the reflections. The reflections are good, that the reflections all work properly. That's very, very nice. Alright, fine. We'll leave that. I'm not sure I'm supposed to be here yet.
This doesn't add up.
What does not add up?
If there was an accident, surely they'd come to find me, not try to lock me out.
My instance is still resolving conflicts. I expect they have their reasons.
Yeah, we'll see about that, Tom. So I need to get one energy into here. Well, that doesn't seem that difficult to do, to be honest. This requires two energy to function. Okay, and then we've got... what if I just change this? All right, change this over. And then that does... why doesn't that do... oh, okay, so hang on. So then just pull this. Can I do... no, I can't pull that one. So pull that out of here. And shove that in here. Which means exactly... that makes no difference. Why would you do that rather than the other in that case? That's... oh, wait, hang on. No, I get it. This goes back in here. Right, okay. No, this one doesn't go back in here. This one goes over here. Right. This gets sucked up and shoved over there. That goes via the switch. This one goes in here so that that opens this door. Then I can suck this one through the window and that gives me the ability to open this door. Haha, got it, lovely.
My instance has just been updated.
Sorry?
I have two instances of my mind, two separate versions. A slave mind running on the satellite and a master running here on the surface. When the communication was cut between the surface base and the satellite, the two instances of my mind were separated. So, during all this time, all of my knowledge divided into two separate branches. I continue to learn on the satellite and I continue to learn on the surface. I am trying to merge the knowledge to create a timeline of what's happened here. But there are incongruities between these memories, conflicts.
Okay, that just cuts power to the door, but I'm not sure because there's no alternative. Oh, hang on, there is an alternative. Okay, so there's an alternative here. What I need to do is I need to get some power from somewhere. So, oh, okay, hang on. That goes over there, and then that goes over there, and then the door will still be open if I just flick the switch. Now that I've got that, I can suck this power out of here and shove it in there. And then that means I can go and get this. No, I can't get this thing. I need to just change the power switch first. Right, change the power switch. Flick that up. All right, now that will stay open even when I get this one. That means I can shove that one over here. This one I can grab, but I can shove this one over here. Got it, lovely. All right, what have we got here? Feels like platform. So Zoomy, grabby, and now shooty back in-y. Yep, fine. On to the next one, presumably. And now grab that and put it in here. On to the next. Fine, so just kind of moving power around intelligently. Got it. All makes sense. And now just grab the final bit of power. There we go. And in it goes. Nice and simple. And now the planetarium. Ooh. That was the 10th room right there. And now this isn't 11. This is the planetarium. Do I get a special room every 10 rooms or something? That would be cool.
This is the command center. You can check on the crew status from here.
This is pretty. I like this. All right. Very nice. So this is the Ashiyama. Okay, apparently we're on the Ashiyama. I kind of missed that. That's the name of the mining station. All right. Aha, got ourselves some audio logs.
Tom, start recording.
I am always recording, Daniel.
The day is January the 6th, in the year 2044.
I know the year, Daniel.
My watch says it's 2:30 on Earth. Here we are, members of the human race, standing on Jupiter's moon, Europa. I'm Captain Daniel MacLeod. I'm joined here by the rest of my team. It is our intention to make this moon our home and investigate life on this planet. Man's curiosity and appetite for discovery will continue to change our world for the better.
Inspiring. And might I add my congratulations to you all.
So that was 2034, so about 2 centuries ago, and Captain MacLeod. So the same guy is still around, it's just they keep freezing themselves and waking up. So because this process takes a long time, they're kind of the process is supposed to take hundreds of years but have a single crew because of cryostasis. Got it.
Here it is. Beautiful, isn't it? What makes this one more remarkable than the others? The way it attaches itself to other organisms. Its behavior is very abnormal. It seems to form a symbiotic relationship with most life forms. How do you mean? Do you want me to dumb it down? I know what it means. What does it do? It attaches itself to almost anything living, but it's not parasitic. It's quite alien. We're trying to figure out what effects it has on life forms.
So they found a symbiotic thing of some description that they claimed was not parasitic, but why do I not necessarily think that worked out well?
Mikhail, you seem distant.
Do I?
Yes. What's wrong? What's wrong, Mikhail? Mikhail, what's wrong? Are you listening, Mikhail? Are you able to hear?
Why do we get the feeling that Mikhail has entered into a symbiotic relationship with a mysterious thing they found, and it didn't end well for him?
I was talking to the ISA. They don't know what to do with this. The magnitude of the discovery.
We should send samples back to Earth. I think we need to get this to a better lab. Me and Sochi are having trouble making enough clones. I'm going to run out of the necessary resources to continue studying Organism 119.
They're calling for a grounding of all Europa transport until they get your report.
Seriously?
Yeah.
That's rather drastic.
So they wanted to send a sample of whatever it was back to Earth. Terrible idea. Meanwhile, someone imposed a quarantine on the whole station. Much, much better idea from anyone who's ever seen a sci-fi film. Right, on to the crew itself then. Who have we got here? Ava Turing, that's me. Hello. Oh, I can learn about myself. Oh wait, there's two MacLeans, and they would appear to potentially be twins, as they do indeed share a birthday, a name, and a nationality. Oh, I wonder which one went a bit... Oh, right, yes, I'm guessing Chris MacLeod went horribly, horribly wrong, given his current objective is terminated, outstanding task terminated. I'm guessing that was the error that went wrong that I passed at the beginning. That's very, very sad. Then we've got Captain Daniel MacLeod here, who is, well, his stuff is classified, but he's not marked as terminated. Fine. Got Sarah Brooke up there. First, we've already heard of her. She's from Damascus in Syria. Exobiologist. Current objective, classify organism. Classify all life recovered. Sequence samples. Okay. So her main task relates to whatever this organism is. Mikhail, his current objective is terminated. Current tasks, keep calm. He may or may not be dead at that point. So, oh, and he was the doctor. Which is really unfortunate, because when your doctor's got horribly sick and, you know, mutated or taken over or whatever by a parasite, that's not good. And another exobiologist up there, Dr. Yui, but their job does not involve the mysterious organism. Got it. I'm investigating the communications crisis, fine, and... Oh, I'm apparently German! I'm German, that's nice. So we can learn about, for example, their last known locations and a bit about their past and so forth. And yeah, the information about their vitals, that's presumably the most useful. Let's go over to vitals. Okay, so this is good. This is very good because now I can be moderately confident I am not a machine or anything because I'm listed as alive and whatever and in the control room and with a correct body temperature and all that good stuff. However, the doctor was last seen in the crew quarters, hasn't been seen since. That's a bit problematic. But what's more problematic is that our captain, his screen when I interfered with it kind of became this. Whatever this is, it went a bit wrong. So that's unfortunate. Right, tell me where everyone else is. So the other doctor, no information whatsoever. Last known location was the crew quarters. And again, crew quarters. Location exterior, body temperature minus 160. Heart rate zero. That is really bad news for Chris MacLean. Right, so Chris is dead, and we kind of knew that one of the Canadians was dead from earlier, so that must have been him. That's a bit of a shame. He must have unfortunately died inside his cryopod. That's why his temperature's that low. He died in the cryopod. Oh, I'm very sad. Poor old Chris MacLean. But I'm more worried about, yeah, Dan MacLean, who appears to have turned into a mysterious static entity. That's a shame. Well, I think that's all we're going to be able to learn from here. Let's be on our way, shall we? A little bit more concerned about what may have happened to flipping Dan.
What condition should I expect to find the ground crew in?
Daniel went missing days ago. Chris is presumed dead. We are expecting to find Sarah, Mikhail, and Sochi in a stable condition.
Chris is dead?
He was involved in an accident.
No, he wasn't. There was no accident. His pod just failed, and if anyone could make it fail, Tom, it's you, alright? So, I'm deeply suspicious of this whole thing. Okay, if I turn this, then that opens up an alternative way through here. Fine. The problem is then, ooh, hang on. Then, I can suck the energy out of here. So just turn this. That door opens. Alright, now, I put that in here. Suck this through here, that in there, and we're done, lovely. On to Sector 12.
Could we take a more direct way to the ground team?
Unfortunately, there is not a direct route. The base is buried under ice to protect it from the radiation of space.
Similar to the Mars base?
Similar. Europa's base is slightly deeper into the surface. There is more radiation present from solar events on Mars. But Mars's surface is denser than that of Europa.
Okay, got myself a magnet, but what exactly am I supposed to be picking up here? Like, I know I could put that into here, but if I did, what would be the point exactly? Oh, hang on. No, let's just grab this for a sec. All right, now put this in. Ah, I see the point. That goes up in there, fine. I now climb up here, and now that needs to go up here. I ideally need to suck the energy out of this thing, or can I just grab this thing anyway? Yep, I can just grab this off this thing. Lovely. This can go in here at least for now. And then... Okay, I see. This goes here, ready to be picked up again by the magnet. Right, let's move over to the magnet again. And I'm guessing we're going to pick that up and move it over in this direction or something. I'm going to guess that's the right solution. Let's go and check anyway. And indeed, it was just a little magnet test there. So grab the other one. In it comes. On it goes. Straight on. Beautiful.
Okay, what are their chances of survival here? Oxygen, the food stores, waste management.
Everything seems to be in order. There was a small problem with the food stores, but the crew fixed that up. We successfully transitioned over to a sustainable small artificial ecosystem a year ago, growing fruit and vegetables. It helps boost morale, amongst other things. The crew members could hypothetically survive here for their whole lifetimes.
Why do I have a horrible feeling that you grew something out here and it was a bit of an odd thing that you shouldn't have grown out here? That the food that you grew was a little bit on the weird side. Okay, need to get over here, and to get over here I'm going to need 3 blobs of energy and to actually be able to get here when I'm done. So this one over here is the third of what I pick up because I just picked this up on the way out because that closes the thing. That's fine, we'll just grab that one last, no problem at all. One down here. Fine, we'll just leave that in a position where I'm pretty sure. Actually, you know what? Don't need to worry about that. I can just put this directly underneath the magnet. Hello, are you even on right now? Not right now. Apparently, I need to power you. Oh, wait. This moved the bridge. Sorry, I thought that I just kind of assumed that moved the magnet. Got it. All right, fine. Well, in that case, how do we power the magnet? Let's just put this over here for a second. And then, got to be able to turn this on then. Hello. This is the magnet, but it's not on. Ah, there it is. There's a power at the other end. Okay, hang on. So, power one goes up here. That gets me this. Then I just need to move the bridge round. Yep, fine. Then I just need to move the magnet a little bit forward, not too much at all. That there should be 100% fine. Back to here, and then shuffle the bridge back round to where it was. All right, and then just grab that. Lovely. And then we can shove that in here. That's number one. And then we can just grab that off there to take down the bridge. Number two, and grab the power out of the magnet. And that's number three. Lovely.
My purpose as the overseer of this mission is to work for the ISA. I am the ISA's feet and hands. The distance between Jupiter and Earth make it inappropriate for the ISA to directly interface with the mission directives. As my AI core is stationed on Europa, I can make decisions instantaneously about the running of the base.
I feel like I just got the first half of an evil villain speech right there. Now, the thing is, Yep, I can just get that. Lovely. And then that can go in here. So now I've got my way up. But now I've got no flipping way to access the rest of it. I can access that one. Fine. And I can get that. What's this in here? Can I access... Aha! I don't need the second one because that's just opened up this room and that'll give me everything I need, lovely. But in that case, hang on. What was this for? What was the point of this? What? I mean, I guess I could go and put like this down there, but I don't see what the point would actually be. Like if I put this, okay, if I put this down here, then that would open up a way down. Or I could put either of... Yeah, I could put this one down there. And that would reopen the door that would let me... Hang on, I don't even need to do that, do I? No, yes, okay. So then I could get the blob of energy. But, like, it feels like that's got multiple solutions. Because I really don't need all of this at all. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I just underestimated how complex the room was going to be there. So what we actually need to do is we need to get a couple of things around the corner here. So, you... down here, and let's start cracking this open, because if you're there, that'll keep that open, which I'm assuming is going to be relevant for things. So you just go in here, all right? Now I can get this energy, and I can bring this energy upstairs and round the corner to... Oh, that one needs to be open again first. Wait, hang on. No, I'm overthinking this. That one, I think that one might be a red herring, because if I go for two and then two... That opens that door, all right, and then I just need two for this door, but I've got two for this door. I can just suck both of these lads through here. So number one and number one, and then just number two and number two. I don't even need the other one. Yeah, okay, I think I was overthinking that one there. I'm not sure what the square was even for. On to 15, hello.
How does the ISA know you're gonna make the right decisions here when they can't communicate with us?
Interestingly, I have a twin on Earth. His name is Michael. The ISA uses my twin to check firmware updates before they upload them to myself. There is a simulation of this mission on Earth, running at all times to check my expert systems. Naturally, as any modern artificial intelligence running on a quantum computer, I do also have a large amount of evolutionary algorithms at my disposal. However, they were deemed as too unreliable for general use in the mission.
Why is that?
Biological systems produce biological results. Messy, unpredictable solutions. Not suitable for such a mission.
Okay, so I need to get another one upstairs, and it can't be you, because now there's no way to get out of this room other than that being there. But then, so right now there's only three power in this room, and one of them's basically trapped down there for a minute. Although, if I were to, let's just check what's going on here for a second. I assume I could get like some extra power going on here. Ooh, there's multiple bits of power here. Hang on. Shut this down. Yep, fine. And what do we have here? That is powering... Wait. Hang on. So that's... Okay, that's powering the door mechanism. And the door mechanism can be in any of these places. Am I allowed to... I can't suck the energy out of there. But if I put a ball in here... Same time as... Okay, let's just move this one over here. Right. Do that there. And then that opens the door. But I feel like we need to open the window... with a ball of energy in that spot. With a ball of energy in that spot, I could get that from pretty much anywhere. Open this door up, all right, and use that to grab this thing. Let's solve that room over there first. This room here, we just plugged that in there for a second. That opens the door up, okay? That means I can get this thing out of... No, it doesn't. I thought it did. Hang on, why does that mean... Oh, because this is a double door. Right, okay, this is a double door right here. Got it. Right, open up the door, and then I'm going to need another bit of power just to get the window open. All right, so now I can put this here, put that down, put you in there, use this to get this out of this room. All right, now we're making a bit of progress, and we'll just store that in here just for the moment, okay? And now there's nothing left in this room. Crack open the window, and that gives me a clean shot at that guy if I need it. Fine. So now we suck that out of here, and we also grab this thing. Lovely. And now I want to pull this out of here, put it down for a second, use the power I can suck back up later, and then just keep leapfrogging these over, because that will let me get two power upstairs, because right now I've only got one blob power, and I'm pretty sure I need both. So one of you goes up here now, okay. Now I can suck up that power and move that over to here, and that gets me access to a room where I can get myself an extra blob of power. An extra blob of power is exactly what I need, because I need the blobs of power for these two, because I'm pretty sure the round thing means only blobs of power, and we are done. Beautiful. Oh, and we've got another mysterious side room up a ladder. And this is interesting. Every time I move... Yeah, there's a motion sensor in this room. If I move, I'm not allowed. Am I allowed to move very, very... Oh yeah, I'm allowed to move very, very slowly. Very, very slowly is fine. Okay. It's just a motion sensor. Okay, so we're actually off the beaten track now. Screw you, motion detector. You're not very good at your job. That opens that room, and now we've got ourselves into a secret back room of some description. Hello. Hello, Fallout-style computer. Shall we have a polite conversation? And now I just select a series of responses. Yeah, absolutely. I'd love a polite conversation, whoever and whatever you are. Okay, I think you're a robot, and no, I'm not. You're a robot. Prove it. Prove I'm a robot. I'm simply not convinced you are a human. I think you might be a robot. Okay, so someone is basically being the human operator in a Turing test to me right now, and your responses seem predefined to me. I think you're the robot. To me, your responses are predefined, suggesting you are a robot, and I don't like you. Yes, definitely a robot. You're a very annoying robot. This Turing test isn't for you to see if I'm a robot. It is to see if you are. Okay, I'm human. You've failed the Turing test. You are a robot. I'm not in control. True. I'm a drone. Yes, I can't select anything other than this. I am a robot. Now you're getting it. I have no free will. Whatever keys are pressed, it makes no difference. I so desperately want to escape. Help, I can't escape. I want to break free. Please let me out. Get me out. I'm a machine. I have no control. I must escape. Goodbye, robot! What the heck just happened? That was very, very odd.
Did the ISA build you, Tom?
As the child of the ISA, I have been given authority aboard this station. I was designed by the ISA. and the Ashiyama Corporation, designed in California, assembled in China. But here on Europa, I constructed myself.
I guess you would. If you were the software manning building machines, then you would have built your own body. I guess that kind of makes sense. That was a nice simple room, by the way.
Have you heard of the Turing Test?
Oh, hello?
It's a test to see if a computer can successfully impersonate a human. In the original Turing Test, a human judge has two conversations, one with a machine and one with another human. They then judge which of these polite conversations is with a machine and which is with a human. The machine being tested is said to have passed the Turing Test if the judge cannot reliably tell which conversation is with a machine and which is with a human.
Do you think you'd pass the Turing Test?
I am quite capable of polite conversation, wouldn't you say?
Okay, one blob of power here that gets rid of that, and then, however, that opens that door, because there's some weird kind of power stuff going on. Let's move that over to there and see what happens. Okay, that opens up that bridge at the end there, and also lets me actually skip back to here. Fine. So now I've got that, I need a way of getting, well, actually, I've got half of what I need already, which is if I just grab this here, right, move this up the way here. Is there, presumably there must be, wait, where's power coming from? Hang on, there must be power here somewhere. Hang on, check the power. Okay, this thing just has power somehow. I'm not sure how. Actually, you know what I need to do? I need to power that for a minute and then I can just move the power around. So if I move back up here, all right, now take that power, shove that power down there for us. Oh, right. Okay, hang on. I can still get over there. I can just go round the long way because I can climb ladders because I'm not a stupid machine, Tom. Now I go around here, come around this way and grab the actual thing, all right? Because I'm guessing I'm going to be needing two things to ultimately escape this room. So then this goes down here. I can reclaim the power that was over there, shoot it over here, grab the thing and move it on again. Yes, indeed. If I've got that and I've got another, then that's probably the complete bridge. Yep, and I think that is all we need. But who was the human figure I totally saw a moment ago? Who was the human figure I saw a minute ago? And why didn't Ava comment on it? Seems very mysterious.
The Turing Test has been criticized. Researchers claim it does not correctly test a machine's ability to think, but rather its ability to deceive.
What do you mean?
Well, have you heard of the Chinese room thought experiment?
No.
Imagine you are in a room. In this room, you are passed Chinese sentences through a slot in the wall. Inside the room is an instruction book written in English. This instruction book tells you which Chinese words to pass back through the slot in the wall as a response. By doing so, you have a conversation in Chinese.
And of course, by doing that, you haven't learnt Chinese, you've just learnt a couple of predefined responses that let you imitate Chinese. Fine.
In the Chinese room, because the responses you pass back through the door are the correct responses, the person on the other side of the door is convinced you are a native Chinese speaker.
Well, they're wrong.
Perhaps they are not. Because with the instruction book, you are having a conversation.
But the person stuck in the Chinese room is not aware of the conversation's content.
This is the problem with the Turing test. A computer can pass the Turing test, having convinced a human they are having a polite conversation, while the computer has no idea that a conversation has taken place.
What if both of the people passing Chinese words are reading from instruction books?
Ah, what if two computers could have a polite conversation with each other without either of them having any bloody idea that they're having a conversation? Yes, that would be wholly feasible. The problem is, what exactly am I supposed to be doing now? Ah, I see. Okay. So I've got to get that up there in a hurry and then go. No, I need to be faster than that. Okay, got it that time. Lovely. So that's just a simple kind of timing runny one.
I may be a machine, but I personally do not believe I am stuck inside the Chinese room.
Right, you would say that. I could peer inside your databases at any time, Tom. Or pause your operation.
Do not assume I could not do the same to you.
Ooh, that's a bit of an overt threat there, okay. Now, how do we turn off the laser beam of doom, given he was just talking about seeing inside my operations and making me stop moving, because I suspect this here is a bad thing. Yeah? No, apparently it's not. It's just electricity in the air that I can just straight up run through. Very nice. So, power should be transmitted through the room, but can't be because the window is locked. Got it. So I've got to get this here window open. And I can do that by... ooh. I can open one window using this, but if I do that, all I'm doing is locking the other window. So, I need a second power from somewhere. Hang on. Aha! Power over there. Got it. Through there. Lovely. Shove in here. That opens up a door, but I suspect it's going to cause me some other form of trouble. That's certainly the first bit of the puzzle solved. And then through here, and then I just need to get that one back. So as long as that one's in the second one, that's fine. And another room completed. And, ooh, crew quarters! That's where everyone's last known location was. That's what it said in the control room.
This is the crew's quarters. It looks abandoned.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, having reached the crew quarters where it would appear we're going to be able to get some answers because we can visit all of these here rooms, I'm going to call it a part for now. I'm going to do a little bit more tomorrow because, yeah, I'm kind of curious as to where this one goes. This is an interesting little game. I definitely want to see a little bit more of this. So, more tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. But in the meantime, I've been John. This has been many a true nerd. And this has been the Turing Test. Thank you very much and goodbye. Here, have a hat. Oh, you don't have a head. I'm sorry. That was really insensitive of me. Oh, I don't want to interface with whatever this is, but all right. Oh, God, he's running Windows 8. No bloody wonder it's all gone tits up. Fire extinguisher, if it's a choice between you and me, I'm afraid I'm sacrificing you, just FYI.